باب مسح اليد بالتراب ليكون انقى. مسح اليد, wiping the hand, بالتراب with mud, meaning wiping, rubbing the hands with earth. Why? ليكون انقى, so that they can be cleaner, in order to make them more clean. Meaning hands will be clean after you use water, but if you use something else, then the hands will be even more clean. Likewise, the rest of the body, if you use water only, yes, your body will be clean. But if you use something else as well, okay, like soap or shampoo or whatever, then your body will be cleaner. Okay, so the cleaner you are, the better it is. The more fragrant you are, the better it is. حدثنا الحميدي قال حدثنا سفيان قال حدثنا الأعمش عن سالم بن أبي الجعد عن كريب عن ابن عباس عن ميمونة أن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم اغتسل من الجنابة. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم took a bath from جنابة, meaning he took a bath of جنابة. فغسل فرجه بيده, then he washed his private part with his hand. ثم دلك بها, and then he rubbed it, meaning he rubbed the hand, الحائطة, on the wall. Okay, and the wall must be of mud. Okay, ثم غسلها, and then he washed it. So after rubbing the hand on mud, then he rinsed the hand. ثم توضأ وضوءه للصلاة, then he performed wudu just like his wudu for salah. فلما فرغ من غسله غسل رجليه. And then when he was done from his ghusl, at the end he washed his feet. Improper washing of the hands, is that a problem? Yes. It can cause many diseases, right? It can cause a lot of problems. So it's necessary that after using the bathroom, hands are washed properly. But even when a person cleans his private part, whether it is in a ghusl, he should, or something else, he should still wash his hands. We also see in this hadith that the Prophet ﷺ washed his feet at the end. This hadith mentions it, and many other hadith that we have read so far also mention this. Therefore, make it a point to rinse the feet before stepping out of the shower. Meaning at the end of the bath, make sure that you rinse the feet. You can wash the feet in the sink as well after stepping out. But the reason why, like I mentioned earlier, the reason why the Prophet ﷺ would step away was why? Because either there would be a puddle of water, or because the mud would be wet and sticky. So let's say you're taking a shower, all the water has gone down the drain. There's no soap, no scum, nothing. The tub or whatever, the shower area is clean. So at the end, can you just take the shower head and spray the water directly on your feet? Yes, you can do that. Or can you wash the feet with the tap? Yes, you can do that. But the last thing that you do before ending the shower should be washing the feet. Because this is masnoon. Because even if, let's say the ground where you're standing, the place where you're standing is clean, there could be something on your foot. Even though a lot of water has been washed away, could be something, you know, between your toes or under your foot or something. So make sure you lift up your foot a little bit at least and rinse it thoroughly. No, but this is not tayammum. You could be in a situation where you don't have access to soap, so make sure that you clean the hands with mud. And mud, really, when you touch it, when you rub it on your hands feel clean. They really do. Unfortunately, the kind of lifestyle we live, we don't touch mud, we don't touch sand, we say dirty. I mean, look at the word dirty. It's from dirt. And what is dirt? Mud. It's something that is considered unclean. Whereas it is actually clean and purifying. And it's good for you. Even over here, you could go to a park and when you use the washrooms, there's no soap over there. What are you going to do? Get some mud from under the tree or whatever and clean your hand. Sand, it's actually good for children to play with too. I mean, in schools, we see that there are sand boxes and things like that so that kids can actually play with sand. It strengthens your immunity as well, right? So it's good for the body, it's good for the skin. The Arabs would send their children off to the desert. Why? So that they would be healthier, because life in Arabia is not easy. So they would expose them to the desert life so that their bodies would be stronger. They could survive in that harsh climate. So likewise, we have to expose ourselves to these natural things as well so that our bodies are stronger. And we see that the more we clean ourselves, the kind of cleanliness that we think is cleanliness, the more sick we are becoming. If you think about it, all these skin problems and allergies and so on, this is a result of what? Of overprotectiveness.